A possible cause of multiple sclerosis may be a common virus carried by 90% of the population. That's according to a Harvard study that found, they found that last month. MS is a progressive disease that affects 2.8 million people worldwide. Right now we've got Slucare neurologist Dr. Lokesh Rukmangdachar, and he's joining us to discuss that. Good morning, doctor, and thank you so much for being here.
Good morning. Thanks for having me.
What is that that common virus we're talking about?
So this is what is called Epstein-Barr virus. It's a group of herpes virus similar to chickenpox virus. It commonly causes infectious mononucleosis in young adults and high schoolers.
Yeah, they call it the kissing disease.
Yes, kissing disease or a glandular fever sometimes. Mm-hmm. But it's also been associated with a lot of autoimmune conditions, including multiple sclerosis and several cancers.
Now, is there a vaccine for EBV, which is what Epstein-Barr is known as?
So far, we don't. I think there was a few years ago, there was a trial trying to get a vaccine, but that failed. But right now, at least there is one phase one clinical trial going on by Moderna using mRNA technology, and we are hopeful that might be successful.
So if somebody had that virus, EBV, there's like a period, usually what, about 10 years where they believe some could get MS as a result of that, but not everybody.
Yes, so it's a very difficult situation so far. The recent study kind of clarified a lot. So as you said, 90% of the people, general population, has this virus infection, but almost everyone with MS has this virus. So that's kind of sparked the interest. But it has been difficult to prove because it's so ubiquitous. Almost everybody at some point gets, right? But in this study, they serially followed the blood samples and established that if you get the virus down the line, you're going to get MS and not the other way around. So it was a very conclusive evidence that this virus is triggering MS. Of course, not everybody gets the virus, gets the MS, right?
Right.
So risk of MS is about 1 in 1,000.
So the key would be to find a vaccine for EBV.
Yes, I think this study kind of makes a compelling case to go forward with the vaccine efforts.
How far away are we from that vaccine, do you think?
So, like I said, we are in the phase one trial. We have to see if this is if it is safe, and then we have to see if it is effective in preventing, say, infectious mononucleosis. But because there is a lag time in developing MS or other cancers, it may take a long time before we know this effort is going to be fruitful in preventing MS.
That's Dr. Lokesh Rukmangdachar. He's a neurologist at Slucare. Thank you so much for informing us about this. And good luck finding that vaccine. We appreciate it.
Yeah.